A power struggle between Sudanese army and a notorious paramilitary force has rocked the country, with more than 50 civilians reported dead. Residents dodged gunfire in the capital, Khartoum, as rival forces battled over the presidential palace, state television and army headquarters. The clashes erupted after tensions over a proposed transition to civilian rule. Both the army and its opponents, the Rapid Support Forces, claimed they had control of the airport and other key sites in Khartoum, where fighting continued overnight. Heavy artillery was heard in most areas and harboring Khartoum and nearby Bari in the early hours of Sunday morning. Eyewitnesses also reported gunfire in the Red Sea city of Port Sudan.
They are fighting over authority.
The army said its jets were hitting Rapid Support Force bases, and the country's air force told people to remain in their homes while it conducted a full aerial survey of paramilitary activity. Residents said they are in panic and fear, with one describing a bullet being fired at the house next door. At least 56 civilians have been killed in cities and regions across the country, as Sudan's doctor committee said, adding that dozens of military personnel were dead, some of whom had been treated in hospitals. In total, at least 595 people have been injured.
I think what's going to happen now that fighting has become so extensive is that it will be a fight to the end, but it will not.
Three employees for the World Food Programme, a UN body that delivers food assistance to vulnerable communities, were killed after RSF and armed forces exchanged fire at a military base in the west of the country. Numerous airlines have suspended flights to Khartoum, and neighbouring Chad has closed its border of Sudan. In Khartoum, people were filmed running away and taking cover as a black smoke crawls over the city. The Rapid Support International powers, the United States, China, Russia, Egypt, Saudi Arabia, the United Nations, European Union and African Union, have appealed for an immediate end of the hostilities. Efforts by neighbors and regional bodies to end the violence intensified today. That included an offer by Egypt and South Sudan to mediate between the fighting parties, according to a statement by Egyptian presidency. The World Food Programme announced its temporary halting all operations in Sudan today. In a statement, the World Food Programme says it is horrified by the news of the death of three of its employees. The World Food Programme added in its statement that one of its aircrafts has been damaged at Khartoum International Airport during an exchange of gunfire, which is said to impact its ability to move stuff and provide assistance to people across the country. Sudanese groups and the ruling military junta failed to reach an agreement last week on handover of power.